everyone. I'm Rachel. Today we're going to be doing a full body workout. This workout is good for all levels. Also, if you're pregnant, like I am, there's pregnancy options that are safe for all trimesters, given your doctor has given you the okay to work out during pregnancy. All you need are two cans right from your pantry, a yoga mat, and some water. Let's get started. All right, let's start with a warm-up. Nice and easy, just getting that blood flowing, a heart pumping, jumping jacks. If you're not feeling that jump, or maybe it's your third trimester, half jack, totally fine. Still moving your body here. Ten more, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, high knees. Get those knees all the way up to your chest. Pump those arms. Prenatal option. Knee to chest. Take away that jump. Good. If you're pregnant and feel up for that jump, by all means, go ahead. I'll go back into it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, going into butt kicks. 3, 2, get that heel all the way to your butt. Let's go. Again, if you're pregnant, option, just kick, kick, kick. You really still want to kick that heel all the way up to your booty. Tend to get out of breath a little bit easier during pregnancy. Good, we have 8, 6, 4, 3, 2. Get nice and low, side to side. In that squat. Chest up, shoulders back. Good. Make sure you're staying low here. Four, three, stay low. Two, stay here. And one, hold that squat for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. We're staying low again in 3, 2, squat, jack. If this is too much, just take one leg at a time. Otherwise, both legs. Make sure you're staying a little bit lower. Then you think you can. If you can, just get a little lower. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We go up in 4, in 3, in 2, and 1. Good. Let's just do some light twists. Nothing too heavy. Inhale through your nose, exhale through your mouth. Good. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Grab some water. Let's take a minute and then we'll go into the full workout. All right, now it's time for the body of our workout. We're gonna start with reverse lunges. So we're gonna take our right leg and we're gonna send it back while bending both knees. So we wanna make sure, I'll step back a little bit more so you can see a little bit more of my body. We wanna make sure our left knee isn't going past the toe. Should be aligned with your ankle. And you wanna try to keep those hands off your hips if you can, maybe keep them in prayer. If you really feel like you're going to lose your balance, bring them to your hips. C see if you can bring that back knee a little bit lower for the last 6. 5, 4, 3, 2, and on this last one, hold it down, let's pulse. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and bring it on up, going right into that left side. All right, here we go. Remember, bend both knees and try not to bring that right knee over your toe. Exhale every rep. Five more, then we're pulsing it out. Last 2, last 1, hold it down, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and come on up. We're going to get our heart pumping a little with some cardio. I love these, they're called X jumps. We're going to take our right arms, and both legs out at the same time and come back in. So, for anyone who's feeling up to jumping, it'll look like this. For anybody who's just not feeling that jump today, maybe you're feeling a little big. Okay, totally fine to do opposite arm, opposite leg, and take away that jump. All right, let's get started. In 3, 2, and 1. I'm gonna start with that jump, and if I need to move down, I will. Now landing nice and quiet on those feet, let's get 10 more. And 1, good. Woo, my quads are already sore. You're gonna go right into squats next. So we're sending those hips all the way back and come back up. Keeping that chest nice and tall, shoulders back. Feet hip width apart, toes facing forward. Me here, there we go. Ten more. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2 on this next one, hold it down for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. We're going into a jump squat in 2 and 1. Jump. If that jump is not for you today, just go back into those squats just like before. For 10, 9, 8. I'm going back into that jump. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Grab some water. And then, once you've gotten your sip, grab your cans. We're going to go into a quick upper body segment. All right, have my cans. We're gonna start with front raises. So make sure your toes are facing forward, feet hip width apart, and your knees are slightly bent. You wanna make sure to keep those arms nice and straight as we raise them up to our chest and back down. These may feel light right now, but I promise you, they'll get heavier as we keep moving those arms. And if it ever feels too heavy, feel free to drop those cans and just continue on without weight. We'll still be working those arms, I promise. Five more here. Five. Four. Are you starting to feel it? Three. Two. We're gonna hold them up on the top. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now take that right arm up and down while you hold the left. We have 8 more here. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and switch. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, it's feeling heavy. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! Shake it out. We're going into side raises next. Burning out those shoulders. Okay, so just like before, feet facing forward, knees slightly bent, and here we go. To the side, and back down. You don't need to go any higher than about shoulder level. And like I said, feel free to drop those cans if this ever feels too heavy. Isn't it amazing that we're only carrying like 15 ounces or something? What are these? Yeah, 15 and a half ounces. Five more. Three. We're gonna hold them up in two. Both. Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and drop them. Good. All right. Don't think I forgot about that single arm up and down. We're coming back to it. First, we're going to go into upright rows. So you're going to take those cans, bring them together, and bring those elbows all the way up to the ceiling. We want to avoid any shrug in our shoulder here. So keeping those shoulders nice and relaxed. Good, let's get 6 more. 6, 5, we gotta get prepared for carrying that baby. 3, 2, and 1. Good. All right, we're going into tricep kickbacks. So everyone is going to make sure that your knees are bent and your hips are hinged. All right, from here, you're gonna go from a bent elbow, extend it back. Bend, extend. Bend, extend. For an extra little emphasis, as you can see, I'm taking my fists and I'm taking my palms, facing them out. Rather than in, I'm facing them up and out. That'll add a little oomph. Exhale every time you bring those hands back. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 2. On this last one, hold it back and pulse. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. We're gonna do some high bicep curls before we go back into those sides to finish out those single arm raises. So we're gonna bring those arms nice and tall, about chest level, and you're gonna bring the hands to your shoulders and back out without dropping those arms, okay? Keep them nice and tall. Make sure you're thinking about your form here. So your knees are bent, your toes are facing forward. We always wanna make sure we're keeping that core engaged. Those abs are still there, even if you have a little belly or a big belly. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, back to the side. So we're gonna start by bringing both arms up. We're gonna hold that right arm up as we bring the left up and down for 10. 9, nice and slow and controlled. 8, 7, don't go faster than I am. 6, 5, 4, I'm shaking. 3, 2, and 1. Other side, here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, woo, 3, 2, and 1. I don't know about you, but during that last set, my left shoulder was on fire. Okay, you'll be happy to know that we are done with those cans for now. So put them down, and we're gonna head to the mat. So we're gonna start with a mountain climber. Get that cardio back in. So, option one here, don't start yet. Just gonna give you all the options first. Bring those hands underneath your shoulders. And you're gonna bring knee to elbow. If that feels good, you can add speed, okay? Option two, for those mamas who are getting big, or maybe you have carpal tunnel, I know I'm starting to get some carpal tunnel, standing mountain climbers. So you're gonna bring that knee to your elbow, okay, and do it standing. So we're gonna get started. Whichever method you prefer, totally fine. 3, 2, and 1, here we go. I'm doing standing, like I said, I have that carpal tunnel that I'm starting to feel. We have 10 more. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good. Headed to the mat now. You're already there. Stay there. So we're going to go into some planks. Again, if you're half carpal tunnel, feel free to go onto your forearms here. I'm also going to give 2 options before we get started. So, first option is a full plank on your toes, if you feel up for it. Otherwise, on your knees. Just make sure if you're on your knees, you're still engaging that core. You want to make sure your knees aren't close up, but still far enough back that you're engaging those abs, okay? So we're going to do a 30-second plank on those forearms, and if you want, you're welcome to go onto your hands if that's more comfortable for you, like this, whichever you prefer. All right, we're going in 3, 2, and 1, 30 seconds. I'm gonna go here. Feel free to do whatever feels right. Listen to your body. Make sure your back is nice and flat, in line with your booty. We're about halfway there. 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Woo! Don't forget, we still have those core muscles, the abdominals under that belly. However big you may be, however you may feel like they're not there, I promise you they're there. So, we're gonna work side planks now. Again, you can go onto your knees or up onto your toes. I'll show you both. So first, on your toes, looks like this. Make sure that that chest is in line with the wall in front of you. On your knees, you wanna make sure that top leg stays out and straight while you're on that bottom knee, okay? So we're gonna do 30 seconds per side. We're gonna start on whatever side you're on now, and then we'll switch. We're going in 3, in 2, and 1. I'll take a knee for this one. You do whatever feels right. Try to bring those hips up a little bit higher. You are halfway there. Breathe through this. 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and good. Other side. Same thing, either on your knees or on your toes. We go in 3, in 2, and 1. I'm looking at my watch here, keeping us accountable for those 30 seconds. Bring those hips a little bit higher if you can. Engage that core. Everything nice and tight. You're halfway. 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice work. Grab some water. Let's get a drink. All right, just grab a sip of water. Now we're going into a quick stretch before our time here is done. So we're gonna start on the mat. And we're just going into a butterfly stretch. Feet together. And push those knees down with your elbows. Take that right leg, extend it all the way out, and reach for your toe, for your calf, whatever you can reach for, whatever feels comfortable. And switch. And come into a nice comfortable position. Take that right arm across your chest. And take that same arm and bring it to your back and pull that elbow for a tricep stretch. And switch. One big inhale through our nose. Exhale through your mouth. Great job today. I'm Rachel. I hope you join me next time, and I'll see you later.